I am Mr. D. J. Doshi, working as Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today's learning outcomes are, at the end of this session, students will be able to classify the different machine tools, discuss the construction of lathe machine. So content in this video are introduction to machine tools, classification of machine tools, principle and construction of lathe machine. So introduction of machine tools, we will introduce what are machine tools, what work the machine tools carry out. Under classification of machine tool, we will discuss how the machine tools are classified depending upon the type of operation, type of material removed and type of work done on it. And third part is principle and construction of lathe machine, in which we will discuss about the principle of working of lathe machine and construction of lathe machine. First one, introduction of machine tools. These are the machines used for carrying out metal cutting processes and surface finishing processes. So the machines which are used for cutting the metal are called machine tools. Each machine can carry out one or more than one type of processes. So under this it will be turning, facing, shaping or forming or giving any shape, which we will discuss under this machine. These are power driven machines used for making the component of desired shape, size, accuracy and surface finish by removing the material on it. These machines are different types of cutting tools remove the material. So machine tools are broadly classified under metal cutting machine tools and surface finishing machine tools. Under metal cutting machine tools, these machines remove major part of the material, which will give the shape and size, whereas the surface finishing machine tools are removing very little part of the material and give it finish or desired accuracy or design fitting required. Under metal cutting machine tools, first one is a lathe machine, in which the job is held in the spindle or chuck and the material can be removed parallel to the axis and perpendicular to the axis. When we remove the material parallel to the axis, it is a cylindrical turning or turning operation which will generate different size of the shafts. Whereas if you move the tool perpendicular to the axis, it will generate the flat surfaces. Second one is drilling machine. It generates the aperture of any size depending upon the tool in the workpiece or in the component. So drilling of machine, in this drilling machine, the job is held on the plate or on the table and the tool will move vertically up and down and around it one axis. So it will generate the aperture in the component. Milling machines can remove the material parallel as well as perpendicular to the table movement, and it will generate the flat surfaces, as well as if the cutter has a convex or concave surface, accordingly it will generate the concave or convex surface of the desired radius on the component. Shaping machines, here the job is held in the bench wise or in the fixture and the tool will reciprocating on it. So it will generate the required surface on the face or side of the face. Now second classification is surface finishing machine tools. As I told, these are to remove very little material, minute material, and this will give only the finished surface of desired size. So first one is grinding machine, where the grinding tools are used to make the surface finish or the cylindrical surface finish or the flat surface finish with the help of grinding tools or grinding wheel, what is called as. If it has a particular shape, then that type of surface finish can be operated on the job or component. Honing machine. These machines are generating the cylindrical hole as a finished surface. So usually these are used for cylindrical blocks or cylinders of the component, or wherever inner surface of the component is to be finished as well as accuracy in size. Lapping machines. These are almost removing very minute material and this will give you super finish by using the lapping tool or polish papers of different size. Polishing machine, these are used to carry out surface finishing on the surface which is machined, which will give you the polished finish. Pause the video and answer this question. What is the main difference between metal cutting machine tools and surface finishing machine tools? I hope you have written the answer of this question. The answer for the question is, metal cutting machine tools remove major stock of material to give desired shape and size, whereas surface finishing machine tools remove minor stock of material to improve surface finish. Now, firstly, we will study about lathe machines. So, what is lathe machine? What are principles of it? And what is the construction of the lathe machine? In the lathe machine, the workpiece to be machined is held firmly and rotated about its axis. So here the spindle of the machine rotates, on which a fixture is mounted which will hold the workpiece, and when we start the machine, the spindle starts rotating, which will make the job to rotate along its own axis, and the job is held firmly in the fixture. So it will be rotated, the job component will be rotating along its own axis or along the axis of the lathe. Whereas the cutting tool is moved relative to the workpiece, that is parallel to the axis, perpendicular to the axis, and or angular to the axis. Now in this case, as I told you, the workpiece is rotating along its own axis or along the axis of the lathe, whereas the tool will either move parallel to the axis of the lathe, perpendicular to the axis of the lathe, or if the angular surface is required, the tool will be moved angular to the axis of the lathe. The cutting tool is made of harder material than the workpiece. So the cutting tool which we are using is made up of either HSS, carbide or diamond. So these tools are harder than the material to be removed, so that we can remove the material on the component on the workpiece. The cutting tool removes undesired material from the workpiece in the form of chips to give desired shape and size. So when the cutting tool moves either perpendicular, parallel or angular to the axis of the lathe, it will go on removing the undesired material. The material which is not required will be removed with the help of tool, step by step. So we can't remove the material at a time, but it will be step by step, which is called as depth of cut. So when you apply certain depth of cut, it will remove only that much material. Suppose 1 mm is the depth of cut, then it will go on removing 1 mm on the surface if it is perpendicular to the axis, or 1 mm along the radius when it is parallel to the axis. So here the diameter will be reduced by 2 mm. So we'll go on removing the material step by step, and we'll give the desired shape and desired size. When we make the tool to travel either perpendicular to the parallel of the axis, it will remove the material in the form of chips or in the form of scrap. So it will give you the desired shape and size. Now, principle and construction of lathe machine. If you observe here, the job is held in a workpiece holding device, which is usually called as chuck, which is shown in the figure. And the workpiece is held in the chuck, which will rotate along its own axis. It may be supported from the front side so that there will not be any movement of the workpiece perpendicular to the axis. Now, in first case, the tool is moving parallel to the axis. So the cutting tool, when moves parallel to the axis, as I told, it will go on generating the cylindrical surface, and the material removed along the radius will be the depth of cut, whereas the diameter will be reduced, double the depth of cut. Now second one is perpendicular axis, the tool movement perpendicular to the axis. In this case, again job is held in the workpiece holding devices. The workpiece will rotate along its own axis, and the tool will move perpendicular to the axis. It will reduce the length of the component or length of the workpiece. The depth of cut will be the chip removed, and the depth of cut will reduce only the length, so it will be equal to the depth of cut. So the reduction in the lathe will be equal to depth of cut. In third case, again the job is held in the work holding device, and the tool will made to move angular to the axis. Now the angle calculations are a different part that we will study or discuss during next lecture or next video. But the tool will move angular to the axis. It should not move parallel to the axis. So it will go on reducing the material or removing the material angular to the axis, and it will generate the surface which is taper surface and give the desired diameter at the end of the taper surface as well as at the starting of the surface. In this case also it needs to support the workpiece from front side, which is usually called at lathe. Now references used are BL Single, a textbook of basic mechanical engineering, Tech Max publication. Thank you.